Alrighty, everyone, welcome back. It is Dreaded D, the infamous pirate captain protecting T-Fuel Island. Today we're going to be talking about the post-pineapple show. Congrats to everyone that got a pineapple NFT. It was an amazing drop. Great to see that things sold out so quickly. Just remember, anything that is said in this video is not financial advice. Please do your own research, alright? And this is just for entertainment purposes only. Alrighty, let's dive into this thing and enjoy. So as always in my videos, I like to start and get a baseline, and I know a lot of you have already seen these things on Twitter, but for those that haven't, this will kind of set the foundation, the stage for the rest of the conversation. So we've seen immense growth in the sales of these pineapples. Things are going very smoothly. I've seen containers now. The amount of container numbers that are on the market right now are dropping very rapidly, especially in consideration of how many pineapples were actually dropped with the 7,800. We're down to 314 now out of 8,088. So once those are open and gone, they're no more. So, you know, not financial advice, but if you want a container or you want to utilize one for a giveaway or an opening for a live stream, I definitely would recommend acquiring one before price appreciation starts to set in, like on the previous drop. You know, when this all dropped last night, we saw that containers went down to about $800 to $700, just about on the low end. And then once that supply started getting soaked up, we're already back up to 1,600. And when the 800 first dropped, we were all the way up to 4,000. So if you want to utilize one or acquire one for marketing, you know, the efforts that you're trying to put forward, in the case of building your own brand, building your own business, these kinds of things can help immensely, especially in growing a community. Even in myself, I've seen massive number of people reaching out to me, finding my videos. It's been great. I'm very much happy. I love you all. It's awesome. So as a baseline, let's just discuss some numbers real quick. So the Mandalorian one, I knew this one was going to be a super popular one. Just didn't expect someone to go out on the secondary market and scoop it up and drop $35,000 on it. That's a significant play there. That's very significant and newsworthy for sure. That's a significant chunk of cheese. These ones I think are almost one of one. Not sure yet because we haven't seen all the ones, but I believe they are, and we'll discuss that a little bit further as we get into the video. Let's discuss the next one, the Deadpool pineapple. This one, after seeing it on the website, you can just almost tell with the color contrast, the background, this was going to be a popular one, and for sure it is. We now have a price floor, some historical context to go by of someone paying $50,000 for it. So obviously, you know, past price, you know, does not always equal future price, but you know, we're kind of in that stage right now where we're figuring out how to value these things, and we don't even know exactly what they fully do yet. And that's what's amazing about it. Right now we're in that speculative price discovery phase, and to see that these ones that are so sought after and that are unique like this are garnering $50,000. That's a significant amount of capital. That's a lot of T-Fuel right there. That could be life-changing amounts of T-Fuel. So not financial advice, of course, but yeah. All right, let's dive into a little bit more as we go deeper into the marketplace, and we'll discuss some more stuff. So as we dive deeper into the market, you'll go through and you'll see that the categories are starting to get filled in more and more. And if you go down on the side, a little bit of alpha here, if you go down, you'll go to custom and look for true. Now there's two kinds with custom. There's the Pingu, which is the basically all of the Yoda NFTs, which I was very surprised to see that there's more than 12 that are on the marketplace at one point. And I honestly thought there would only be a handful of those, like a very rare sought after item. I did not expect to see more than 12 of those. Very surprised about that. But with these, if you go down to custom and click true, you'll see all the ones that seem to be exclusive ones, the ones that are basically one of a kind, or maybe have only a second variation of themselves. And those are going to be valued very highly, as they're already showing. And the two that we just looked at earlier are both part of those custom true NFTs there for the pineapples. And it's clear that they are yielding a certain amount of value in their rarity as a custom pineapple NFT. The other thing to consider when you're going down in the marketplace, we're starting to get a baseline too of what's rare, what's not. It's hard though because you're only getting the factors that are available in the market. There's a lot of people that are hoarding their NFTs right now and are not putting them all on the marketplace. So you're only seeing and getting a baseline by what's out there. So, you know, you got things like the background, you know, the hair and the hat, the accessories, the eyewear, you know, what clothing are they wearing, and you're seeing the frequency. So you can kind of build a baseline model in your mind because there's a decent amount, there's a good spread on the marketplace, but it's not everything. So accessories, and you can kind of go down and see what's rare in contrast with others. And maybe it's not rare. Maybe it's just that it's infrequent, just because certain people are hoarding certain ones. But just keep in mind that, you know, there's 8,888 of these things, and that you're only seeing a small sample size, but this gives such a good baseline to work with and to see the rarity and kind of build that baseline. So I'm looking forward and hoping that someone from the community is compiling all these traits and maybe submitting some stuff to Rarity Tools and or Secret Pineapple Society themselves is, now that everything's out there, is going to be submitting some percentages of what's rare, what's not. I know that's probably challenging with some of these custom ones, but it'd be very interesting to see what's the most rare. Are skulls rarer than that? Are skulls rarer than Yoda's? Certain clothing rarer? Are the accessories? Are the pin, the SPS pin, is that rare? Does that, you know, unlock certain stuff? We're kind of in the thick of it right now. And we are just going through the motions of trying to figure out and sort through what is valuable, and it sort of takes a inclination and sort of intuition and trying to get in the head of the founder, basically. And much props to him. This is very, very exciting. These are beautiful pieces for sure. So let's dive into the auctions next. There's only a couple days left. It's amazing to see that these people are competing for these NFTs. I'm debating if I should throw my hat into the ring, but there's some serious heavy hitters on this. You know, they're throwing around a serious amount of change. I've seen, especially on a couple, you know, over $20,000. That's very serious. But I think that with what they could get by applying that amount of capital, I think they would be very pleased. So we'll discuss that a little bit later. But let's talk about these three for now. So we have the Rambo likeness from the top. You have the John Wick likeness in the middle. And then you have the Predator NFT. One of my favorites for sure, as I am a big fan of Alien vs. Predator. One of my favorite movies, only second to Pirates of the Caribbean, of course. So what's interesting about these three is that these three seem very oddly timed. Now, obviously, this could all be speculation. Big shout out to the Research Squad and Crypto Detective No E for some of these speculations. And please, entertainment purposes only, of course, as we dive deeper into this. So there's been talk of like Rambo 6, a rumor, and the owners Lionsgate and Theta and Lionsgate have a partnership from doing movie nights and, you know, just content creation. So as well as John Wick, the fourth one. So, and that should be coming out in 2022. That's also owned by Lionsgate. Seems very interesting coincidence. Now Predator 5, you know, that's going to be launching in 2022. And the owner's Disney, and if you've watched my previous videos, Disney is very, very tied in with LGU+, and LGU+ is tied in with Theta, basically. So a lot of stuff in the video regarding Netflix, South Korea, and broadband, and I definitely recommend you go check that out, as there's some good information in there. So all three of these seem to be very timely with movies that are dropping. Now, whether that's coincidence or not, this and that, who knows? But, you know, fun to speculate, of course, and just enjoy the process. The next thing is that, just remember, one of these people that is going to win these NFTs and spends the most amount of money, the most amount of capital, the basically the king of the hill here, on one of them, whoever does that gets this Neo Matrix NFT, basically, which is very, very oddly timed as well, too, because Matrix is, you know, there's stuff coming out for the Matrix on the same front as well. So there's a lot of action going on in all three of these, and then this one is the fourth. And it's very, very curious if there's any relation. Are we digging too deep as a research community? Who knows? We're going to find out, though, that's for sure. So so as I was doing my research, though, and listening to some other people, getting some other thoughts and some feedback, shout out to T-Fuel1000X, of course, super research gnome, amazing, awesome dude. Go follow him on Twitter for sure. So then I found out that November 30th, the Matrix Resurrections, they're launching their own NFTs on November, at the end of the month here. So I'm like, huh, this is all very oddly, you know, oddly coincidental. Also, the fact that the Rare Robot here are the founder of the Secret Pineapple Society. Big shout out to him for sure. Go follow his Twitter. And if you aren't following the Secret Pineapple Society on Twitter, please advise you to do so for sure. He worked at Warner Brothers as a 3D artist. And now as you read this, Warner Brothers teams with Nifty's to launch 100,000 unique Matrix-inspired avatars. So maybe we're reaching, maybe we're not, maybe we're connecting dots that may not be there. Who knows? Fun to speculate, though, and see that maybe there's some connection here at a deeper level, and to kind of peel back the layers of what is potentially going to be coming about with all these pineapples here, and what it means for these other NFTs as well, too. Maybe on this one we're reaching a little bit, but I just think it's a very interesting coincidence that it's all within a about a 10-day time period of which the Matrix NFTs launch. And because of that fact, the other thing too that's very interesting is that the platform that those ones are launching on, Nifty, is owned by the Winklevoss twins and Gemini Exchange. So very interesting, because we've had some stuff with Theta TV, with Mark Zuckerberg's sister being on Theta TV, hinting at Metaverse, and then you have Winklevoss stuff on this side of the aisle. So it's either, you know, one is true, one is not, or the Winklevoss twins and the Zuckerbergs have made their amends and it's time to build the empire. So we'll have to wait and see. Or Theta's looking at a looking for some Gemini listing before a Coinbase listing. But obviously, this is all speculation. Please do your own research. Please, please, please. We're just kind of trying to enjoy the journey and kind of sort through which maps and which trails lead to certain places, which ones have false leads. But that's part of the fun of it, of course. So I hope you all had a very successful drop on Friday, and hope you got what you wanted or are seeking it out in the secondary market as we speak. Yeah, it's great fun, honestly. This has been a great experience. It actually, you know, brought some of my friends and some of my family a little bit closer too. We made it a whole event, had a whole like dinner unpacking night, basically, in which we all unpacked our NFTs at the table. And you know, of course, with anything, that commenced the discussions of trade and you know, which vehicle will you give me for that Yoda NFT, of course. So it was fun. We had a great time. I think that's what's beautiful about these small communities and building them out, is that you can become closer with a lot of other people, and you know, even in the digital world, for sure. And that's what I really love about this space, is it really puts a positive spin on a external world that sometimes seems very, very negative at times. So yeah, let's dive into one of my, you know, I had a great poll. It was very exciting, and of course, you know, I'm very selective about who's going to be the second you know, the lieutenant to the captain of my pirate ship, for sure, the second in command, the right hand man to the king. So without further ado, welcome the second member of the pirate crew. Now, this one is very, very special. I had to dig in a little deep because I had seen this one on the Secret Pineapple Society website on the main page with a bunch of other rare ones as well. And I just to test it out and see, you know, where this one stands in the ranking. This is considered a custom one with all the other, like the Star Wars ones and everything. I thought it was a blue skull at first, but I put it on the marketplace to test it. It did not fall in the blue skull category. And if you actually look at the blue skulls there, the eyes are actually different. These are rounded out, whereas the and they're almost gray, and the color is slightly like teal almost, instead of more blue. So very, very interesting. I think it's one of a kind or one of two. I haven't seen another one like it. But very, very, very cool pull to have occurred for sure, especially considering everyone knows that I am a big One Piece fan, which is a very big Japanese anime pirate show. Very, very big fan. And you know why I'm a big fan, especially after this pull? Is because who's the right-hand man to the pirate captain in the show? Is none other than Zoro, the three sword style master, Roanoa Zoro. And look at that. I got three swords rocking there. So, hey, if you guys know what the likeness of my pineapple actually is, this is just the one that I related to the most. And, you know, obviously I got tunnel vision, so yeah, if you could let me know if I maybe, you know, go in the wrong direction, or you know what the likeness is, or maybe the rare robot there can point me in the right direction. But for now, I'm going with Zoro on this one, as he is the right hand to the king in the show, and one of the many future protectors of Teafuel Island. So very, very cool pull. Very excited about this one. Had a lot of fun for sure. I think that's going to do it for this evening. And I also have a video that I made of Zoro related to Teafuel and Theta a while back. I'll be reposting it on Twitter for you guys to see, with some edited subtitles related to Theta and Teafuel. But I won't post it in here just because I don't want to get a copyright strike on my YouTube account. But yeah, had a great time. Hope you guys all enjoyed it. Looking forward to seeing more of your pineapples for sure, and growing the grove and seeing what's happening. So alrighty, everyone, that's going to do it for tonight. And looking forward to seeing you all on Teafuel Island. Alrighty, everyone, take care.